Shall reign over the house of Jacob, and of his kingdom there shall be no end.
How can these things be, seeing that I have no husband?
The Holy Spirit shall come upon you, and the power of God shall overshadow you. Therefore, this holy offspring will be called Holy Emmanuel, Jesus, the Son of God.
I am the Lord's handmaiden. Let it be done to me according to your word.
God had sent the angel to Mary with the message that this child was to be the light of the world. To think that the hope of all creation hung on the answer of this young girl. And so it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first done when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. Everyone was to be taxed in his own city. And so Joseph went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, to Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David, to be taxed with Mary as a spouse wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn child, and wrapped him in soft swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds watching over their flock by night, and lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. The angel of the Lord said unto them, fear not, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be unto all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, you shall find the baby lying in a manger.
Thank you.
baby lying in a manger. Yes, the Word had become flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld His glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Just a small baby, she makes angels sing.
Mary and Joseph took him to the temple of Jerusalem to offer a sacrifice and to present him to the Lord as the law required. While they were there, a godly man named Simeon was led by the Holy Spirit to come to the temple. God had promised him that he would not die before he saw Christ. Simeon blessed the baby and praised God, saying,
O sovereign Lord, as you have promised, dismiss this servant in peace. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you prepared well in the sight of all people. A light for revelation to the Gentiles. Glory to your people, Israel.
Sometime after Jesus was born, during the time of King Herod, wise men came to Jerusalem from the east and asked, where is this one who has been born the King of the Jews? We have seen his star in the east, and we have come to worship him. Now when King Herod heard of this, he was greatly disturbed, and all of Jerusalem with him. And he inquired of all the teachers of the law and chief priests where the Christ was to be born. And they replied, in Bethlehem of Judea, according to the prophet Micah.
In the wind.
Selected and called out 12 men to be his special followers, his disciples. He did not choose all 12 disciples at one time, but over a period of time, these were common men, working men such as fishermen, men who would be capable of carrying on the work he had established when he ascended to the Father. Among these 12 were Andrew and his brother Simon Peter, my brother James, the son of Zebedee, Philip, Thomas, and Matthew, Bartholomew, James, the son of Alphaeus, Thaddeus, Simon the Zealot, and of course, Judas Iscariot, the one who would later betray him. Many times he would draw us to him, away from the crowd, teaching us things of the Father and of himself, truths that we did not always understand, but accepted in faith as we chose to follow him and to do his will. Listen to some of his words about himself. I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, for he has the light of life. A man who walks by day will not stumble. When he walks by night, he stumbles, for he has no light. You are the light of the world. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good deeds and praise your Father which is in heaven. Jesus loved the people, and they seemed to love him. In fact, it was at a social event that he performed his first miracle. At a wedding of all things. Thank you. How can one describe the impact of the man Jesus upon the people of Galilee? To an oppressed people whose hope for their Messiah had dimmed or was completely gone. He was a light in a dark world, a radiant flower in a desert, a stream of cool water to a thirsty soul. He preached with spiritual power, taught with compassion, and ministered to the people in love.
My name is Martha. We're from the village of Bethany. It was my sister Mary who anointed Jesus with ointment and wiped his feet with her hair. Our brother Lazarus was sick. We sent word for the Lord. We waited, but he didn't come.
Him.
no one has ever written. Untie it and bring it here. And if anyone questions you, tell him the Lord needs it. And they went, and they found it, just as he had told them. And as they were untying the colt, its owner said, "Why are you untying the colt?" And they replied, "The Lord needs it." And they brought it to Jesus and put him upon it. And as he rode along, people began to take off their clothes and lay them on the ground before him. And as he came near, people began to shout in loud voices, "Hosanna! Hosanna to the King who comes in the name of the Lord!" met secretly in an upper room, which had been prepared to celebrate the feast of the Passover. While we were eating, Jesus said to us, "I tell you the truth, one of you will betray me." We were all very sad. We began to ask him one after another, "Surely not I, Lord." And Jesus said, "It is the one to whom I dip a piece of bread, which I have dipped in the sauce of this dish." And then he gave the bread to Judas Iscariot. And to Judas Jesus said, "Do quickly that which you are about to do." After Judas had taken the bread, he got up and went out into the night. And while we were eating, Jesus took the bread, offered thanks, and broke it, and offered it to us, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body." After that, he took the cup, gave thanks, and offered it to us, saying, "Drink from it, all of you. This is the blood of my cup, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins."
When you eat this bread,
Jesus was betrayed by a kiss. Then he was arrested, and he was taken before Caiaphas, and before Herod, and before Pilate. And that crowd, who had only a few days before shouted Hosanna, now turned upon him like a pack of rabid dogs, and shouted for his death. The hate in that crowd was as palpable, as evil, pulsating in an excited heart.
Are you the Jewish Messiah?
He's your
Messiah! Don't you hear what they are saying? Each year, I can release one prisoner at Passover. Whom shall I release to you? Jesus, your Messiah, or Barabbas? What shall I do with Jesus? Crucify him yourself, for I am innocent of the blood of this good man. The responsibility is yours. Guards, take him away.
Crucify him.
Then Jesus was marched slowly through the same streets which he had ridden in triumph only a few days before. Only this time, the king of the Jews wore a crown of twisted thorns and staggered beneath a heavy cross to a hill called Golgotha, the place of the skull.
But you are who you claim to be. And save yourself!
Thank you.
Yes, the Word had become flesh and dwelt among us. And that Word is Jesus, and He's still dwelling among us today, and will one day return. Thank you.